so I'm just gonna fix a few of these. First of all, I think the white over here stretches too far out, so let's make sure I do the correct layer. Alright, then I'm going to bring in some of these gray areas here. So just gonna bring in quite a bit here and then just blend it a bit better over here. Same thing goes for this one over here. Zoom in a bit. And yeah, just try to blend as best as we can get it to be. Right. So more or less something like that. As for this top part over here, if I switch my brush, again, I want to blend this as best as we can, and then because I want those areas to be a bit darker, change my brush size to a bit smaller. So just paint around these areas here. Right. So maybe you can paint all the way around if you want. And then again, we'll do the blending job. So, airbrush and try to blend as best as we can, maybe small amount. So again, we try to do our best, get it blended as best as we can. So I'll just leave that for now, and then I'm just gonna focus on this guy. So I can use the same layer, I guess. So I'm gonna use my lasso tool again. And same thing again, use this correct color for that, and I'm going to cover these areas as well. Wait for that. Alright, so probably I just want to do a bit of blending over here around, so maybe from the inside out again. So I'll just use just one of these grays here, go back to my brush tool. And then we'll try to blend it as best as we can get it to be. Maybe I'll just a bit darker here. Just do it just slightly, not too much for these parts here. Yeah, we'll see how that looks like in Maya later on. But for the most part, this is okay. I mean, let's try to blend these areas a bit better as well. Alright, so we'll see how this looks like in Maya. Right, so for the most part, this part here is not having a proper blend, because let's notice that this area here is dark grey and then here is light, so we have to make sure that this area is kind of darker gray as well, so it will blend slightly better. So let's try to go and fix that, but for the most part the rest should be more or less done. Alright, so let's try to go ahead and do that next. So because this area here match up with some of these areas over here, so let's go back to Maya first and see where are these corresponding edges. So I want to understand where these edges are at in our UV space. So they're the ones that's on the outside, so that's part is gonna be a bit darker. So let's go back to Photoshop and try to fix that. So again, we'll use a bit of a darker grey. Maybe it's a better idea for me to sample this grey here. And brush. Oops, on this layer instead. Okay, let's sample the correct one again. Oops. Alright, so same layer. Alright, so we're going to make sure these areas here are more or less the same as that, and same for this one over here as well. So we'll try to see how this looks like with that first. Okay, again, save these people out. Alright, so it starts to seem a bit better. You won't be able to get it perfectly done unless we bring it to like a substance painter or something like that, but what we can do is we try to move around some of the UVs just a little bit so that we can try to get it as best looking as we can. So as you can see, these are these areas over here and these are some of these areas over here. So let's see, we can start with moving some of these UVs over here. Alright, so it's this UV over here, which maybe can blend inside a little bit. Alright, so we just try to move some of these UVs around, try to get them to match up as best as we can. So this guy can go in a bit to the dark side. Alright, so just small tweaks like that to try to get it to work. So again here, so this guy here can go a bit more to the darker side. And even over here I can move it slightly a bit. Alright, so again, like I said, you won't be able to get it exactly 100% done, but something like this is more or less okay. You'll probably see the character from a distance about here anyways, so yeah, so we got the base color done. For the next part is we're going to start to add some details. Let me just change this as well. Where is this guy? Right up here. So we'll change that, maybe we'll bring him up a bit. Okay, so we're gonna add the details next for the next part. Alright, so we're back in Photoshop and I'm gonna start to, so I have this layer here and this layer here. I'm gonna start to add rust and some dirt on it before we add like our diamond texture. So create a new layer. So I'm gonna put it in between here since it's gonna be for this guy over here at the bottom. I'll choose my brush, and this time if you look on the Photoshop, we have different brushes over here. And this is called grunge brushes or something like that. So you can pick some of these different brushes and try to play around with it. So as you can see, I get some of these metal deflects, I guess, if we put it on over there. Right, so let's reduce the size first and foremost. Not too small, maybe slightly bigger than that. Alright, so we can start to put it there. For this part, probably want to use like a dark brown, and then yeah, I'll change the opacity later on. So we'll try our best to kind of like add as much of this as we can all around here. Right, I don't have too much of that, so there's something like that will do for now. Then again, just change to something else. So let's see what else we have over here. Again, we have to kind of experiment. So maybe I'll use a 66 brush and I'll change it to a slightly different color. And same thing again, we'll try to add some of these spots and flicks inside this. Right, and perhaps one more. Maybe a 500. Yeah, maybe this guy. And maybe I'll just go with like almost black with this. it's just a bit long. Then maybe I have a few of these in slightly different color, maybe a bit of a like brown, like almost rust color like that. So just add a few of these inside around here. Alright, so next thing is we can start to blend this. We use our blend mode over here at the layers. I can try to change around the different blend styles to see what looks nice. So this looks kind of nice, but let's explore what we have. It's not bad either. So it's this. So probably I'll use a vivid light, I guess, or linear light is okay as well, and I'll bring the opacity down just a bit. Don't make it too obvious, right? Maybe we can about by half. And lastly, we can put a bit of a blur. So I'll go to filter blur and Gaussian blur, just a bit of a blur, right? About 0.8, I guess, would do well. So that works for this part over here. So you can maybe go ahead and do some over here, but I think I'll just stick it over here, and then we'll start to do that diamond things. Alright, so before that, I'll just see how this looks like in Maya. I'm gonna save this out as a JPEG. Maybe reload it. You can see some of these metal flakes happening down right over here. Maybe the opacity is too little, and I can kind of like duplicate some of these layers up a bit further. So let's see what we can do with this. Let's bring the opacity up just a bit, and I can duplicate it one more time and probably bring it out. Let me see. Let's try to scale it just a bit. Alright, let's see how that works. I have two layers of the same thing basically, and save this again. Yeah, maybe that will work slightly better, so you have some of these textures going on at the bottom. Again, if you do it a bit better and spend a bit more time, I was just doodling it over there, so if you do it a bit better, spend a bit more time, you can get slightly better results, right? That's my advice to you. Alright, so welcome back. What I've done is I quickly went to search for image of like a diamond or checker pattern. So depends if whether you want to have something like this or something like this, alright? Doesn't really matter for now. I'm just gonna copy one of these images here and I'm gonna bring it to Photoshop. Right, and maybe I'll create a new layer here and paste it over here for now. It looks super big, but it's okay. Let's just use our magic wand tool, select one of these. Maybe I'll select the red one over here, and then I'll isolate this guy. So copy him and put him in a new layer, and this one you can delete away. So I have a basically a texture of a diamond shape thingy. So we'll go and reduce the size, reduce, and the idea is that I want to create some of these patterns all the way around here. Right, so let's apply this for now. Okay, let's have a look how it looks like over here. So let's see if we can just put it one here, and then start to duplicate again and see if it works here as well. So as it goes around here, we might need to kind of reduce the size and play around with it just a little bit, because the UV space shrink some sort. Alright, so there's nothing too much we can do about that, but yeah, something that we have to be mindful of. Perhaps it's best to just start it over here. Right, and then we work our way around so that we won't get a distinctive seam over here. So I'll apply this, and then this guy over here. Oops. Just want to make sure that we rotate him around the correct way. And we can kind of use our arrow keys to move him around a bit. Right. One more time. So perhaps at the last part here, I might need to reduce the size. Okay, maybe I'll reduce the size for this one as well, just a bit. Okay, and this one so that the front one has more space. This is my texture here. Okay, so this guy. Reduce him just a bit. Okay, and move him here. And try to reduce him a bit more. Something like that for now. We can go ahead and merge these layers up. Oh, I didn't merge the right one. See this one, and this one. Okay, merge them up. And let's see how it looks like. Just curious how it looks like in Maya. So let's go and save this up again. And we'll reload this so you can see how the pattern more or less looks like all around. You might want to change this one to make it a bit smaller, it's kind of intrude over here. So let's go and do that next. So go back to where they were individual layers, and it's this guy over here. So maybe I'll make it a bit smaller. And again, it's a bit of a tedious process where you have to move some of these guys around, so I have to move him around as well. Maybe I will leave a bit of a gap in between some of these guys here. And lastly, this one. Yeah, just a bit of a gap, I guess. Alright, so maybe I'll save this one more time, see how it looks like. Save this as our JPEG. Yeah, it looks slightly better if it goes all the way around here, but it doesn't really blend properly, so let's go and fix that next. First, merge all these layers up, and we'll see what would be a good blend mode for this guy. Blend with the metal gray color thing we have over there. So just scroll around to see what works best. So this pin light looks kind of okay. Soft light's too light, I guess. Probably we're just gonna stick with pin light, I guess. This seems to give us the best results.